This video is sponsored by Skillshare. Be one of the first 1,000 people to sign up at the link below to get a 2-month free trial. About 1 year ago, I made a video about what I thought were the best note-taking apps in the world. And quite frankly, the amount of research I did for that video almost drove me insane. But guess what? We are back, baby. And that is because there is a new note-taking app on the block, which has a small but dedicated base of users who will tell you that it is the best note-taking app that has ever been made. The tool is called Rome Research, and after getting a not insignificant amount of tweets from you guys telling me to check it out, well, that is exactly what I did. I've been using Rome for about the past 2 months on a pretty much daily basis, putting it through its paces. So in this video, I'm gonna be breaking down what Rome is, how it differs from other note-taking apps, and giving you some pros and cons so you can decide whether it's worth testing out for yourself. So when you start using Rome, the first thing you're gonna notice is that when you're creating pages here, everything is essentially a gigantic bullet list. And if you're used to tools like Workflowy or Dynalist, you're gonna be right at home with how you actually take notes. Everything's a bullet list. You can kind of drill down as much as you want. And what I've found is this kind of bullet list structure here encourages me to write a lot more when I'm in research mode for video than I would if I was using Evernote. When I research with Evernote, I eventually end up with just a gigantic amount of, research vomit on my screen, and it gets very difficult to find certain things after I've written them. But with Rome, everything can be organized through a couple of different functions. First, if I don't wanna see everything, say I don't wanna see everything in this work from home tools section here, cause I'm working on a different part of this outline, I can just collapse it, which is great. So I've already made my crafting your environment video. Let's just collapse that. I've already made my planning and prioritization video. Let's just collapse that. Let's say that I'm in the research process for my time and motivation video, which actually just came out a couple of days ago. I can just kind of minimize everything else I want and work here, which is great. But if I really want to focus in on this specific part of my outline, I can actually just click that bullet and that kind of becomes the top part of my page. So it's still part of this page and I have some breadcrumbs here that show me sort of where I am within my document, but this is all I wanna see and this is all that I'm gonna see, which is pretty nice. So far this is looking kind of like Workflowy or Dynalist. So what's the difference? Well, the key difference lies in how pages link together. See, Rome is a tool for bottom-up associative thought. It is not a tool for hierarchical top-down organization, unlike almost every other note-taking app that you're going to use. So the way that you would do this is you simply put brackets around a term, and if that term is a page, it's going to create a link to that page. If it is not a page, it's going to actually create that page. So let me go ahead and find something within this document that I want to link to. I'm pretty sure I had mentioned I want to make a huge YouTube course someday, kind of a goal of mine, not a super high priority right now, but you know, I want to do it. And I happen to know that I've created an outline here in Rome, kind of brain dumping some ideas. So if I highlight this YouTube course term right here, and I just give it brackets, it'll actually give me suggestions of pages that already exist, in this case, just one, and I can click it, and I've created a link. So if I go ahead and just click this, it's gonna take me to my YouTube course brain dump here. And if you look at the graph overview, which is another kind of unique element of Rome Research, you can see that when you create these links, you start to get this gigantic web of interlinked pages. Now, before we go any further into Rome's feature set, I want to talk a little bit about the point of this linking system. And I was doing a lot of skating while I thought through the structure of this video, so I'm just going to play some footage of that here to make it a little bit more interesting. But when you think about the way that your brain organizes information, it's very much a tangled web of ideas, which is itself made up of a tangled web of neurons. And whenever you have a realization, or you get an idea, or even when you get a rush of emotion about a certain experience, different neural networks start to connect to each other. As the neuropsychologist Donald Hebb famously put it, neurons that fire together wire together. And the more connections a group of neurons has, the more frequently you access it and the stronger the knowledge it stores becomes in your mind. And Rome seems to be built to emulate this way in which the brain works. And it's also very similar to an analog system with the exact same purpose called the Zettelkasten, which was created by the German social theorist Nicholas Luhmann. Luhmann was incredibly prolific, writing over 70 books and over 400 academic papers during his career. And he managed all of his knowledge using a wooden
file box that contained thousands of paper note cards, each of which represented a specific idea and linked to any other card which mentioned that idea.
Now, while the analog Zettelkasten system used this very complex system of numbers to link the cards together, Rome makes things infinitely easier by simply linking the pages together when you create those bracket links, or even when you don't. And this is actually one of the key features of Rome that makes it really, really nice to use. Anytime you mention a page, so let me just type the word books here because I have a page called books. Anytime you mention the name of a page within your text, even if you're not thinking about it, you create what's called an unlinked reference. So if I go over here to books, I can go down here and see four linked references. But if I open up this little menu here, I'm gonna get 9 unlinked references. And these are just any instances within my Rome database where I have typed books, but I haven't put the brackets there to actually link them to my books page. Now, sometimes I don't really wanna make a link because I'm just saying the word books, but if I do wanna make a link, I can come in here, I can look at my unlinked references, and I can just click link for any one of them. And now I've actually made that link. So if I go back to my How to Work From Home Effectively series, then books is now linked to the books page where I'm actually tracking all the books that I'm reading. And this is at least one of the features of Rome that has the fans of this app calling it a complete game changer, because it kind of gives you an opportunity to go back in, interact with the notes that you take and the concepts that you have learned and taken notes about multiple times, instead of just taking notes and then having them be siloed in some far flung, you know, subfolder of your hierarchical system. You are constantly linking the new notes that you're taking back to older notes. And again, over time, you get this very complex, tangled web of ideas. And you might be wondering, well, what's the point of that? And it all has to do with associative thinking. When you combine multiple disparate ideas, well, that is when creativity happens. I mean, think about like a piano. Let's take a guitar and hit the strings with hammers. Boom, you got something different. Or how about, you know, rollerblades? Let's take shoes and put wheels on them. When you take disparate ideas that haven't been connected before and you give yourself tools for connecting them, then you have more insights and you become more creative. So that seems to be kind of the whole point of the underlying kind of bottom-up linked structure of how everything works here. Now, before I move on from linking, I think people in the comments would roast me if I don't mention this next point, which is that pages are not the only thing that you can link together. Anything that is a block, or I guess a bullet, can be linked to any other bullet. So let me give you an example of that. I have one called Working From Home, How to Stay Focused. Okay, let's say I want to link to this from some other part of my outline. Down here, maybe I'm working on another section on work-life balance. Cool. So let me just say, I wanna link to that other thing. All I need to do is, instead of typing brackets, which link to pages, I will type parentheses, and then boom. Now, before you click away from this bullet, you're going to see just a key reference to that specific block. But the moment you click away from it, boom, it is now a block reference. And if I click it, it is going to zoom me right to it. And this is a very, very long bullet list, so I'm gonna scroll up to the top. But as you can see, this is that exact subsection of this page, and I've zoomed to it. More importantly, now that I've created a block link, I now have this little number 6 here. And if I click that, I can see in the sidebar here, anytime I have mentioned this specific block within this page. And I guess that actually brings us to the sidebar. The sidebar is one of my favorite things in Rome. So basically, I can bring up any other note within Rome in a sidebar next to the note that I'm working on. So let's just say I'm over here on my books note, and I don't wanna click into one of these books, I just wanna look at it in a sidebar. If I shift click it, it's just gonna bring it up, and then I can interact with it in the exact same way that I would over here. Now, of course, there are some cons to using Rome, and there are gonna be a couple here that may be deal breakers for certain people. The biggest of which is that at present moment, there is no dedicated mobile app for Rome research. There's no Android app, there's no iPhone app. Now that being said, there is a workaround, which is that you can bring up Rome research in Safari or a mobile browser, and it does work pretty well. And I think they kind of know that the mobile experience isn't super great at the moment, because by default, when you first load up Rome in a mobile browser, you're gonna get a little quick capture box, and anything you submit to it gets synced to your Rome database later on, and it gets put under a quick capture tab or tag. So if I actually go and show you my quick capture thing, these are all things that I've just typed out as I've been out and about, you know, going about my business using my phone, not having access to my computer. So it does work. It's just not the most elegant system in the world. And I think it's going to change in the future. Con number two, there is also currently no API. So if you are, say, an Evernote user and you're used to lots of integrations with, say, document scanning apps like ScanBot that lets you easily scan receipts and other kinds of stuff into Evernote, you're not going to get that here. And you're not going to get any other kind of integration right now. There's also not optical character recognition or OCR, so you're not going to be able to scan your handwritten notes and digitize their text. And also, this is not Notion, which means you don't get some of the really cool features from Notion, namely the amazing tables and database things. I do believe you can create tables within Rome, but they're very, very simple and they absolutely do not hold a candle to Notion, where I can do, you know, multiple views. I can create templates for my databases. I can do all kinds of really, really cool stuff. So personally, Notion is sticking around for many different purposes, not least of which project management, also actual video scripts, because again, I love to format them like this. I love to have tables of contents, all kinds of cool stuff. But Rome is awesome for research, which kind of makes sense because research is in the name. So that is what I've been using it for, and I've been outlining my videos in it, and it has been a great tool so far. Now, one of my additional main uses for Rome has been to take detailed notes from books, because I've been in the habit of getting up every morning and spending a little bit of time reading. And when I read nonfiction, I actually mark up the book with a pen. I know that's gonna be sacrilege to some of you, but for me, marking up the book with a pen allows me to highlight things and kind of makes the book more valuable overall. It also forces me to really engage with the material and pay attention to it. And I know if I am daydreaming. Anyway, once I'm done with a chapter, I will go over to Rome, I'll go back through my book, and I'll write detailed notes, which I can actually show you right here. Here are some of my notes from the book Hyperfocus. I'll write my notes based on the highlights in my book. And writing these super detailed notes has, number one, helped me to actually learn better from the books that I'm reading and retain the information more effectively. But number two, has given me a ton of ideas for videos, a ton of great research for videos. So overall, this is a great habit to be in, and it's definitely one that I'm going to keep up going forward into the future. And if you want to build your own strong habits and actually stick to them, then I would recommend going and taking my habit building class over on Skillshare. This is a class that will show you how to break your goals down into small, actionable habits, and then show you how to set up systems that will help you stick to them over the long term. And turning tasks that take willpower into habitual actions that really don't is a huge part of achieving your goals. And I worked really hard to make sure that my class will help you do just that. Plus, it's on Skillshare, which means that if you are one of the first 1,000 people to sign up with the link below, you're gonna get a 2-month free trial and you'll be able to take that class for free. You'll also have access to thousands of other great classes on Skillshare, including my friend Ali Abdal's new evidence-based masterclass on how to study for exams, plus classes that can teach you new skills in video editing, public speaking, illustration, and lots more. Premium membership on Skillshare starts at less than 10 bucks a month, so it's also a very affordable platform. And once again, if you're one of the first 1,000 people to sign up with my link in the description down below, you're gonna get a 2-month free trial with unlimited access to the entire platform. So that is it. Thank you so much for watching. And if you wanna learn more about Rome, my friend Nat is actually the one who introduced me to it, probably via his incessant tweeting about it, but he's got a great overview article that you may want to check out. So I'll link to that in the description down below, along with the Rome Research subreddit and a couple of tutorial videos that you may want to check out if you really want to dig into it. Beyond that, I'm interested to hear what you think of both this app, but also note-taking apps in general. What are you using these days? Are you doing it on a computer? Are you doing it on an iPad? Are you back to a regular pen and paper system? Let me know in the comments down below. If you enjoyed this video, definitely hit that like button to show the YouTube algorithm what's up. Subscribe right there, or check out one more video on this channel right over here. You can also follow me on Instagram at @TomFrankly if you want to see some new bonus tips that I'm putting out from time to time over there. But of course, you don't have to follow me over there, and you don't have to do anything I say, because as always, I'm not your dad.